Hello, and welcome to another edition of Night Terrors Phantoms, brought to you by Commando Gaming and Battletech Battles. We're excited to continue this series of the Battletech Heavy Metal DLC as we continue our journey through the Inner Sphere and see what exciting mechs we can put together for you. So we're excited about continuing this series. We're going to do another video of an hour and a half or so, and then we will go on to the next chapter. So, as you saw in the last video, we had a very contemptuous battle where our beautiful Centurion had some significant damage. So we're kind of on our beat, and also some of our 18 pilots got hurt. So we're definitely on the B team as far as mechs and pilots. So what we're going to try to do is see what we can do with our B team. So we have what is really a new mission type, which is basically we have to take our mechs. We have to take one of our mechs to an enemy site, get it infected with a virus, and then return the virus back for analysis. So this is actually a pretty good mission for us to take on, given what we have available. We're going to max out our salvage. And the reason we're going to take this mission on is it's not a destroy the enemy mission. So what we can do, while we want to get salvage, we still have the ability to complete this and evacuate. So that's what we're going to do here. So our assassin kind of becomes our lance leader. Our enforcer, sorry. Our assassin. Actually, we're going to put the Irby here. Really doesn't matter where we put the mechs. I just mentally like to think of how I'm going to handle the strategy for the mission. So we're going to have to put our best pilot in the enforcer. Our number two pilot probably in the Irby here. And you need to either take Blazer here or Lawyer. So I'm going to put Teacher in the Assassin. I'm going to put Lawyer here in the Cicada. I'm going to take the three piloting and the four guts here, because what I envision happening is I'm going to use the Enforcer, the Irby, and the Assassin to engage any enemy mechs, and I'm going to use the Cicada to kind of rush in, get infected by the virus, and rush out, because that's our primary mission, is to get infected by a virus and bring it back. So I envision the Cicada, since it's my least powerful mech in this lance, to be focused on completing the mission, and the other mechs are going to try to get as much salvage as possible. So that's my game plan here. You know what they say about plans? They only stay in their current version until you actually fight the enemy, and then all bets are off. So let's see what happens with this mission and see if we can succeed with that operation. Let's see what we can do here. May have picked that up on the mic. My dog and cat are continuing their antagonistic relationship. It's not very often that you have a 50-pound dog that is bullied by a 10-pound cat, but that's what we have in our house. Command interface initiated. So my dog, who is about the nicest dog ever on the planet, doesn't have a mean bone in his body, is kind of bullied around by our cat, which is basically Satan in a cat form.
Ready to rock, Chief.
There are dog people and there are cat people. I think you could figure out what I am. All right, so we need to get our mech here, our cicada, into this target zone here. So it looks like there's a secondary base over here. I've actually never seen this map before, unless this is a variation on another map. It's kind of cool. What Harebrained Schemes does when they design these maps is basically they design a huge landscape and then they take slices of it and use it for each mission. So theoretically, this could be a completely different version of a map that I've seen 100 times. It's just a different part of the map. So I love that they do that here. So we have this road that's going to take us to the objective, but 9 times out of 10, the last thing you want to do is take the road. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our mechs and go in the opposite direction of the road. It's never a good idea to follow the road. Unless, for example, you're escorting, and then you kind of have to do that. Or it's really mandatory for the mission to follow a road. Yes, you move faster. You do move faster, but it's usually a situation where you get ambushed. As you can see here, we're going to be probably in a much better place if we don't follow the road. Especially when we have our slow-ass Irby here. Although it does have jump jets. And so does our jumpy assassin.
Copy that.
Although we're not going to jump there, because I don't want to build up the heat.
Waiting for order.
We got our Irby. We have our cicada. Now our cicada, his primary job is to get down to the objective.
No order received.
No targets, we'll just brace the cicada there. Alright, we got a Shadowhawk. Ooh, a Shadowhawk would be really nice salvage right now. Given what I have in my lance. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to see if I can't sprint over my enforcer.
Orders.
And is the Shadowhawk the only? No, I got probably a vehicle as well. So what we're actually going to do, jump over the assassin. Now the assassin, we've got a javelin. So the assassin can't handle a Shadowhawk, but what it can do is it can act as a distraction while we get everybody else in line. We got a locust here.
How's it going?
Gotta kind of get our Irby in a position where he can become a part of this. The Irby's armed with a PPC, 50-50 shot.
I'll get up quiet.
Of course he was going to miss there. So again, remember, our goal is to get our cicada to the facility so he can get infected with the virus. We want everybody else to focus on being a distraction and getting some tasty salvage.
Refeeding you.
So what we're going to do now, what we can do here, normally I would be sprinting my cicada in here, but the cicada could actually probably keep some decent evasion. As you can see, it's got 5 evasion, and it can also get involved in helping us a little with this fight. Get some a little bit of damage in on that javelin. Shadowhawk. Gonna attack my Irby. That's fine with me.
Careful! You don't want to scratch the thing.
I'm happy with that. So our enforcer. So we need our enforcer to get to a position where he can start engaging the Shadowhawk. We need to start working off the armor on the Shadowhawk. The Shadowhawk is definitely the biggest threat and the best source of salvage here.
Yes, Commander.
So we've got our assassin here. Now our assassin, I think, is best served by jumping to the flanks. And I know, in theory, it should be attacking these lights. But it's got good hit percentage. We want it to distract the Shadowhawk as much as possible here. Irby to really help us.
You know,
the Irby is a great walking turret, right? So now that it's in position, it should help us with this Shadowhawk. Again, if they're going to attack anybody, I'm happy with them attacking Irby here. You know, obviously the Irby's taking a bit of a beating.
Waiting for orders.
So next up, we need to keep working our cicada.
Location confirmed.
Towards the primary objective. And at the same time, get it to help us with the Shadowhawk a little bit. Fortunately, the Shadowhawk missed on that shot against my Enforcer. But that does tell me the Shadowhawk is shifting targets, so we need to keep the Enforcer with some evasion. And at the same time, we need to hit that Shadowhawk. Again, that Shadowhawk is the biggest threat on the field.
Commander.
And our assassin actually could put itself in position to actually get the virus, I think. Yep, okay. So the assassin now is going to be infected with the virus, so it changes our plans a little bit.
Roger.
We'll go ahead and use that assassin to attack that Shadowhawk.
The asset has been secured and is ready for retrieval.
Alright, so now we have the option to get to the evac zone. So what we're probably going to do is do a fighting retreat here.
Getting banged up real good here.
We're going to start to slowly move, emphasize the slow, because we're talking about an Irby, towards our evac zone. Now, the Irby here can really help us out if it can take out a leg on this Shadowhawk. And, of course, it's not going to do that. taking a pounding here. The good thing about the Irby really is the fact that it does have decent armor for its tonnage. Now, if we could just take out this leg on this Shadowhawk. Oh, that really should have done it. I mean, that really should have taken out that leg. So, need to keep moving towards the evac zone. And also really try to take out the Shadowhawk. Right now, both legs are in a world of hurt.
Standing by.
Alright, so we have our assassin. Now, the evac zone is, yep, I figured it would be completely in the wrong direction. So, but what we do have, we can move the assassin over here so the cicada and the assassin are at least fighting together. We can hope that we get a knockdown here. Not gonna happen. Irby is in trouble.
That shot hit internals.
Forcer is also in trouble. Alright, so.
Standing by.
Our Irby really is not in a position to. We need to take advantage of the long-range weapons of the Irby, specifically the PPC here. So it's not going to be able to shoot with this PPC without overheating. Now the question is, the Irby, no, we can't do it. So we're just going to shoot our large laser, got a stray shot there. What's the locust gonna do? Locust is gonna go after.
Armor blow through. Internal damage.
Keep moving our enforcer. We've got to get our lance together here. Hopefully we can also take out a leg, maybe. Nice. And we got a pilot injury. So what we actually want to do is we want to try to keep hitting that. Take the shot on the javelin here, actually.
What's up, boss?
Alright, now we're going to take advantage of our assassin's ability to take evasion off of a target here, specifically off this locust.
I got it.
Because we want to keep knocking the Shadowhawk down because it's our best chance of getting salvage on this guy.
Commander.
Shadowhawk here. Alright. We're only gonna get one piece off that Shadowhawk. That's kind of disappointing. Really giving us a hard time. So, now that that Shadowhawk is off the field, this is going to make this a little easier. I was trying to be a little sophisticated, see if we can get a full Shadowhawk out of this mission. It's not going to happen. So now, we really need to get these guys off the field as quickly as possible.
I got you.
So it's going to be straight up hit percentage. Let's go ahead and hit this locust. This should take out the locust, hopefully. I took out a leg.
Reporting. Critical hit.
Cicada is going to be about what we can get off the field as quickly as possible, which is going to be this focus, hopefully. No, not quite.
Orders.
The assassins. Now the assassin, I could use it to take out the locust, but that defeats the value of the assassin, because the assassin is so good at getting shots at mechs that have evasion. So we're gonna have it shoot at that javelin. The javelin's gonna shoot my enforcer. Oh, going for the Irby. Oh, head injury. Brutal. Brutal. Move up for Irby. Irby's whole job is going to be hopefully to get rid of this locust. That locust is taking a beating and still ticking. Enforcer's taking a heavy hit there.
Let's
try to get the enforcer into some cover. Great hit percentage here on this javelin.
Here we go.
Gonna take that. Locust is going to get up, but really doesn't have that much to hit us with at this point, so that's fine.
Receiving you.
I'm going to try to do try to get one of these javelins off the field as quickly as possible. There we go. And a torso hit. Bravo.
Ready for orders. Heading out.
Right, this is a good chance to take some evasion off that javelin. Have to take that shot. Medium laser to the rear of our enforcer.
Waiting for orders. Let's do this.
Cool. Move up our Irby here. Let's try a PPC shot to the leg. Yes! All right, so the javelin's down. It's got no evasion. Winkle here needs to take advantage of that. And here we go. Let's get rid of that javelin.
Target down.
Good to go.
Our cicada can finish off this locust. It's eliminated. Successful mission. We got some fair amount of damage in that mission, but we got some good salvage, so it's going to be kind of a catch-22 here. We got a little bit of sea bills. We got some damage, which we need to strategize about. We got a Shadow Hawk part. That's good. I guess we have to take the two javelin parts. And sadly, we have to take the locust part. Other than that, we'll take the two SRMs. Take two SRM-6s. Would have been really nice to have gotten a mech out of that mission, because our mechs are really taking the beating here. Let's jump into the barracks.
Standing by.
Commander, orders?
Training complete.
We're in a tough spot here because our resources are whisper thin here. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. So I've got 4 pilots.
Take off your shoes. Make yourself.
See what we got going in the mech. Enforcer's got a little bit of structural damage, but of course the armor is refreshed when it comes back. So we could probably... So let's see where the structural damage is. So it's in the front armor. So that's a little risky. We've got the Irby. Where's his damage? His damage is in the... Ooh. Leg. So, kind of risky to send the Irby out there. The cicada, it's pretty much fine. Got a little bit of damage in the shoulder and the arm. So, we've got 4 pilots left. We've got four mechs that we can use. We just have to be really smart about how we use them. So, let's see if there's a really easy mission we can take a chance on. So, there's this hostile territory mission, or there's this insurgency leader mission. So we're going to take a chance here. Very upfront with you. If I was looking at this from purely a mech commander standpoint, I'd probably say, all right, let's just travel to another planet, lick our wounds, and live to fight another day. But, I really want to see what we can do here. So we're going to take a chance here. And we're going to roll out with this mission. Alright, so as you can see, our Enforcer's got some structural damage, our Irby has some structural damage, our Cicada has a little bit of structural damage. Basically, what I want to do here is try to get salvage on a mech that I would replace one of these guys with, and then I will just scrap it, and then we'll probably either take the last mission. I think we can handle. I don't think we can go above 1.5 skulls with the mechs that I have available, and the pilots for that matter. So we might, if this mission goes perfectly, maybe we can take on that 1.5 skull mission. But then again, if I get a mech, a good-sized mech that has the ability to get on the field right away, that might change our scenario here. So with an assassination mission, I'm a little suspicious of this only being a one-skull mission, because typically in assassination, you have some escorts, and then you have the primary target. And the primary target at this level of the game is probably in a medium mech. Sometimes it'll end up in like a small heavy, like a quick draw. But it might be in like a Shadowhawk, which would be nice, because I'd love to put a Shadowhawk together right now. Okay, so we've got the insurgent leader here. We've got supporting enemy forces there, and we've got reinforcements. So this is a tricky deal. So we got the insurgency leader way up there. We've got the supporting units there, and we've got reinforcements coming in from a distance. So, interesting. Oh, okay. So I've done this map before. And
I'm there. Picked up a blip.
You can get up on the lip of this canyon. One thing I can do is I can actually jump the assassin.
Roger
that. That's not what I wanted to do. Jump the assassin up there. See what we got. Because I'm outnumbered here pretty significantly, and it's not like
this looks like a prime spot for an ambush.
I have a
be
huge amount of firepower.
You don't want to get caught in a crossfire. All
right, so can we So it's going to be faster to jump the Irby up to the top of this cliff. Right, we're going to shoot at our assassin. He's got great evasion, so I'm not too worried about that. Alright, so blazer.
Get
Here's our assassin pilot. So what I want to actually do is we just... So if I jump my assassin in here, start shooting these guys in the flank. Try to cause a distraction.
Commander.
All right, sprint up.
Confirmed.
Yep.
Can I get farther up this canyon by sprinting or jumping? Definitely by jumping.
Waiting for orders.
Probably the same thing here. Ooh, alright. I can actually get to a position to fire here with our Irby.
Locked on target.
Ooh! Great hit there on that Panther. Hit the center torso. That was very fortunate. Oh no.
Damn it! I'm wounded.
Oh no. Not good. Do this very often, but we're gonna back out of this mission. I don't have a problem doing this because it's really for the stream. What I would do if I was playing this live, I would probably just withdraw from that mission. The reality is four. Three lights and a medium against nine enemies is... I knew that mission was probably going to be not as good as what we have. So, I wanted to give it a try. And again, normally in... If I wasn't doing a video, I would probably just withdraw and take my lumps. But again, I'm trying to get you guys as much good gameplay as possible. So we're going to fudge a little bit. So, so I'm going to travel here. And I'm in a tough spot because... What do I have at the store I can sell? Because I'd really like to get the third mech bay going, but it's going to cost me a lot. All right, so fortunately, I have a commando I can sell. I have a javelin I can sell. Some jump jets I can sell. We'll keep five jump jets. Right, so that gets me to 2 million C-bills. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have engineering.
I've got some things to update you on, boss.
Work on this other mech bay. It's going to take half of my money.
It'll take a bit, but we'll get it.
And 20 days, but it's going to be worth it. Now I need to get these repairs going. 3 days on the Enforcer. 3 days on the Irby. 1 day on the Cicada. So I know the mech bay is going to take 21 days. So it's in my best interest to pick a destination that's going to take that long. I also need to maximize my repairs, so I have as many maxed as possible when we get to our destination. So, I really need my Centurion back. So, probably gonna be the best solution there. Is we're gonna have to travel. Now we have our financial report in 10 days. That's okay. I have enough money for that. Our mech debay is gonna take 20 days. I mean, the reality is we're just in a tough spot here. So we need to. Let's see, we've got a 19-day travel mission, which will actually pay our freight. But it's going to take us to a 2.5-skull mission. I don't know, planet, I don't know if we're ready for that yet. 2.5, 2... Rhinefield is a 2. Aretas Prime is a battlefield, which means we might get good salvage, and it's 18 days away. Mithrion is 27 days away. We're going to go to Arteris Prime here. I don't know if we're ready for a 2-skull planet. I just don't. We're going to take this Arteris Prime. It's going to cost us 60,000. It's going to take us 18 days of travel.
By your command.
But we got a lot of things that we need repair-wise. So we're going to bite the bullet there. Our pilots are coming back. Our mechs are coming back. All good stuff. That one battle where we lost our Centurion really put us in a tough spot. All right, so we got our financial report here. Any second now.
Got a new financial report for you, Commander.
Oof. We are running out of cash. Be okay though. All right, middle of the night, you're flung in bed. Metal scratches deep inside your Argo. Dr. Muhammad's voice crackles in the comm. Everything's under control, Commander, but Beloved needs adult supervision. Darius drags the pilot into your quarters. Beloved discovered how to destabilize a dropship with a pen laser. They say it was an accident. You've got a lot of accidents. Luckily, nothing major, but this one nearly sent the drive destabilizer flying into the fusion reactor. How do you want to handle this, Commander? We can take Ed out of Beloved's pay. I don't think that's a good idea. Enforce discipline. I can spend 100,000 to train. 100,000 is a lot of money right now. You know what? I'm going to use the money to train Beloved. Unavailable for 14 days. Gains high spirits. I probably shouldn't have spent that money on that training. You never know.
Our next day is just about gone, Commander.
But now Darius is not happy because we're running out of money.
Looks like we've arrived, Commander.
All right. So we're here at Arteris Prime. first and foremost. I've got my four mechs back. Again, I mean, this is not a good lance for me to engage in pretty aggressive missions. I can't wait 12 days for my Centurion. It's just not possible. Alright, let's see what we got available in the barracks. As far as pilots, we got our player character back. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pilots. 7 pilots available. 11 will be available in 12 days. Hothead in 5 days. So we got reinforcements coming here. Check in the hiring hall here. Ooh, Hellion would be a really nice addition. So would Majestic. So, I'm always prone to hiring good pilots whenever I can. So the question is, what not so good pilots can I jettison at this point? So we got Blazer.
Yeah.
And Lawyer. Are probably my worst pilots right now. So Blazer, you are dismissed. Lawyer. I'm not a big fan of Lawyer here, so I'm going to dismiss her as well. Hiring good pilots early in the game are worth their weight in gold. So we are going to hire Majestic, which is a really good pilot. I know it's costing me a lot of sea bills.
New mech warriors available.
And we're definitely going to hire Hellion here.
New mech warriors available.
Might want to come back and get two strike. We'll have to see. So I'm happy about that. Now I've got some really good pilots here.
Let's do this.
Right. So that's worth it, in my opinion. Especially since the mechs I have right now are super squishy. So, let's look at the contracts that are available. We're going to take this recovery mission. Max out the salvage. And we need to put our best pilots out in the field right now. So the reality is Majestic is a better pilot than my player character. So he's going to take the lead. We'll put my player character in this Irby. I'll put Hellion in my assassin. Even though his piloting is only a 2. And put Twinkle here in my cicada. So one thing I really need to do is to develop somebody who could be my sensor locker. I really don't have a character right now. Thank you. We'll see if we can get this mission in and maybe one more before the end of this video. So, what I really need here, I need some good salvage. That's,
command interface initiated.
I need some salvage to really... I need a medium mech that I can add to this equation.
Lovely landscape here. Simply lovely.
A Shadowhawk would be nice. Right, so that's where we need to get to the target zone. Alright, so somewhere in between the target zone and us, there should be some enemies.
Heading out.
So, let's get going. Look how fast that assassin is. The assassin really could be the ideal scout. It might be better than a flea. Because if you can use an assassin to take out the enemy lights and be your scout, I think it's a really good situation. Alright, so we got a something with a PPC, probably a panther. And we got a spider. Okay, so nothing we can't handle here. Alright, so we can move up our Herbie. We can start hitting these guys at long range. Oh! Knocked out and a leg destroyed on that spider. Nice job, Night Terror. Why, thank you, Night Terror. I say that because he's my player character. Alright, so we got another target, unknown mech, coming up.
Yep.
So, we can actually get vision on this. Probably a panther. Yep. Let's see if we can start getting that panther. Spider gets up. Can he get in range? He can, but he misses. He shot at my assassin. Probably not the best thing to do. Assassin, right? So, unfortunately, my enforcer is super slow. So all we can do is move up and brace with him. Oh, we got a Phoenix Hawk. Oh, everybody, we got our first sighting of a Phoenix Hawk.
You have orders?
Exciting and new. What is this? The love boat? I guess it could be the love boat. Let's move up. We want to kind of move away from that Phoenix Hawk because it's Jumpy McJumperson and the fact that it's got... we want to try to maybe take out this panther before we have to worry about the Phoenix Hawk. Let's see. The Phoenix Hawk's moved. Move up our Irby here. I want to avoid being flanked by that Phoenix Hawk. What are the chances that we can get two leg shots on this spider in a row? Not good. Although we almost took that leg out, second leg. And the other target is a locust. So with this enemy lance, the priority target's going to be the panther.
Waiting for orders.
And then we have to deal with the Phoenix Hawk as well.
Copy that.
Alright, maybe we can get a center torso strike or a leg strike on this spider. Get it off the board. Alright, there goes the spider. Nice. Oh, here comes the Phoenix Hawk. Oh, the Phoenix Hawk didn't jump, which surprises me, because the biggest advantage that the Phoenix Hawk has is the fact that it can jump and shoot with better accuracy. Why this panther was retreating, I don't understand.
Here we go.
Maybe it knows that we're after it.
Reporting.
you can see the Panther is trying to protect its PPC. Would have liked more evasion. Hit that Panther. Not the arm I wanted to take off, but did some good damage. PP shot on our Herbie, which is actually, I can live with that. Okay, so we're going to keep moving this way, away from the Phoenix Hawk. Really like to, see if we can get this Panther off the field. Not too worried about this Locust. But if we can all... Oh, head injury. Darn it. Nothing worse than those head injuries. I'll keep focusing on this Panther. There we go, Panther out. Phoenix Hawk's turn. Ooh. Rear shot on my Enforcer.
My internals are taking a beating.
Not good. Not good. Alright, so what we're going to do here is move up. I want to focus on taking out this Locust. Number one, because most of my lance is over there. Also, because if I can get 4-1 on that Phoenix Hawk, maybe I can maximize salvage.
I got you. Okay. Repeat it. Glorious. Show them what you've got.
Locust move. Probably come in, hit my rear again. So I've really got to protect that Enforcer's flank at our rear at this point. Gotten 2 shots to the rear. Set up our battle line here. Don't have a great shot at this Locust. Maybe we'll get lucky. Took off some evasion. No, the Phoenix Hawk. Oh, so toasty. So toasty. My Enforcer is... His rear is toasty. I already know. I got real lucky with the Enforcer there. So the Enforcer has got to turn around.
Moving on.
Off that Locust, just to get rid of it. Alright, now
what
we really need to use Jumpy against Jumpy, right? So,
engaging Jump Jet.
Let's try to use our Assassin to keep this Phoenix Hawk distracted. Alright, we already got some damage on the leg.
Ready to rock.
Possibly.
I got you.
I'll use the cicada. Number one is cannon fodder. Number two, if I can get out, get this leg. Oh, so close. Herbie to the rescue. All right, I've got a precision strike. Now, what I want to do here, if I can take out this leg. No, I was really trying to take out that leg there. Alright, we got another shot. Let's maximize our chances of taking out this Phoenix Hawk's legs. goes one of his arms, at least.
That is something good. Let's do this. Knocking on target. Score the critical hit. How might I help?
I like more evasion with the assassin, but I would really like to take out that leg if I possibly can. No. Alright, so the Peacehawks looks like it has medium lasers left. So, name of the game. Knock him down, hopefully. Oh, lethal. Wait! Head destroyed lethal damage! A headshot? That could mean.
Location confirmed.
That we got three pieces of Phoenix Hawk, which would be lovely.
Of course!
Lovely.
Not
I
that,
can
Commander.
Desperately use a Phoenix Hawk right now. Alright, all targets eliminated. Now, how many pieces of that Phoenix Hawk did I get? If I got a successful shot, we got a injury for 17 days. That sucks. But we got a Phoenix Hawk. Nice. Nice. And we got a Panther. Okay, so this could really turn things around for us. All right, so we're going to confirm that. This is gonna be interesting. Number one, I'm excited to get a Phoenix Hawk. I love using Phoenix Hawks in the early stage of the game with Rogue Tech, so I'm assuming it's gonna be similar here. Plus, we kind of have two really good flankers in the Assassin and the Phoenix Hawk, right? So this is good. This is good. Really good salvage. We should have time for one more mission here.
That mech is ready to fight, Commander.
All right.
That mech you wanted is back online. That mech you asked for.
Oh, I got a locust.
That mech is ready.
And a spider. Whoa, Christmas come early. All right, so I need to make some decisions here. So, right. First, easiest decision, goodbye to the Irby. Can go to storage. Panther or Cicada. Cicada goes to storage. And the Locust goes to storage. And the Spider goes to storage. Wow, that was a very productive mission for us. First thing I like to do is go to the store. All right. So, Irby. I gotta sell the Irby. I'm sorry, Irby fans. I just can't justify keeping an Irby around. Keep one of the spiders as a backup, and I'll keep the cicada as backup. So let's go to the mech bay. I'm hoping I can repair the Enforcer in a day. Ooh, 4 days. Oh, that's painful. That is really painful. But I really don't have a choice. So we're going to have to repair the Enforcer. It's going to have to go to the top of the list for repairs. Going to advance some time now. The mech bay will improve, so will be completed, so that will help. That sped up the Enforcer by a day. So let's look at engineering real quick. We will prioritize getting the most. So we got scaffolding for 270. Repair harnesses for 270. Time is money, so we'll spend the extra money to get something done in 10 days.
I'll get the team on it right away.
Basically. That's basically what they're doing is time worth more than money. And time is almost always worth more than money. So our Enforcer, we need one more day for repairs. Okay. Alright, now we've got our Enforcer, we've got our beautiful Phoenix Hawk. Come on, show me the Phoenix Hawk. Let's go to the refit, not because I want to make any changes to this, I just want to view the mech here. So another thing we can do here is kind of look at the different patterns we can do here for this Phoenix Hawk. Ooh, I like that red race car look. Probably what we're gonna go with here. Yep, I like that red race car look. Nice. That is a cool looking mech. I mean, it's gonna be a flanker. So looking at our Lance as it is now, so we've got our Enforcer and our Panther, which are gonna be basically our long-range, heavy firepower units. The Phoenix Hawk has 3 firepower for its size, but a lot of that is machine guns, so I don't know how much we're going to use. It has a large laser. So we're going to use that to flank. The Assassin is obviously great for flanking. So let's get one last mission into this video. So we've got aggressive negotiations or corporate secrets. Or we have turn the tables. Try this recovery mission first. All right, let's figure out. Doesn't really matter that much where we put these guys, but it helps me mentally to come up with a game plan. So I like to put my skirmishers in the first section and then my flankers in the second section. Doesn't really matter where you put them, obviously. All right, we'll put Twinkle in the Assassin. And put Gilsaid in the Phoenix Hawk. And we still have Hellion and Majestic, since my player character is knocked out. So we'll kind of use the Enforcer and the Panther to tank. They're not really the best units for tanking, especially the Panther, but that's kind of what I have to work with here. So, and then we have to use the Phoenix Hawk, and we have to use the Assassin to flank or go after lights. So that's going to be the game plan here. See how that goes. So once again, this will be the last mission of this particular episode. But we're going to be cramming in as many episodes as possible. Everybody's excited about seeing some gameplay here. I'm excited about playing this game. So we're just going to keep cranking out as much gameplay as we can. Got to go to that target zone on that top of the hill. So we probably want to, we have to go up this way or around that way. Usually I like to go the longer way, the less expected way. Strategically, that's the way that usually makes sense. Oh, look at the speed on this Phoenix Hawk. How far can it jump? Oh, boy. So I've got two jumpy mechs in the Assassin and the Phoenix Hawk. So let's take advantage of that. Keep the evasion as high as possible. Really high evasion on both of those guys.
Ready to rock.
Send our scouts up ahead. The Phoenix Hawk can actually jump farther than it can sprint. I love that. That's awesome. One thing I will do, anybody who's watched my videos, I'm not a big fan of jump jets. I'd rather have weapons and armor. But we also can't spend our mech bay time right now.
How might I help?
Making largely cosmetic changes to our force.
Lifting on.
We don't have the luxury of that, so. I mean, I know how to use jump jets. And for the Assassin and the Phoenix Hawk, they make total sense. For other mechs, not so much. So we've got unknown mech, and my guess would be maybe a vehicle there. So.
Skipper.
Right, these guys do not have any heat right now, so let's go ahead and jump the Assassin. And we got a javelin here. We'll definitely take the shot on the javelin here. Ooh, head injury. Nice. Assassin still's got a ton of evasion.
Waiting for orders.
Alright, so the Phoenix Hawk, we're not going to jump.
What did you see?
Because I should have jumped because I would have got more evasion. Really good hit percentages here, so let's take that. I wanted to be able to fire that large laser. Ooh, PPP shot on our Phoenix Hawk.
Standing by.
Alright. Jump to get our enforcer ready for the next round and the brace. Shooting our assassin. Should be okay.
Awaiting orders.
Alright, so our panther can move up.
Moving out.
Save his heat and get a good shot on hopefully this javelin here. Nice. Alright, so we have four mechs. So four on four here.
Waiting for orders.
Let's move up our enforcer here. And we kind of have this javelin isolated, so we're going to keep going after this javelin. Ooh, somebody's got a PPC over there. Alright, so we need to keep jumping our Phoenix Hawk.
What are your orders, Skipper?
And our assassin here. So, do a short little jump on the assassin, mainly to try to get some evasion going here. A little bit of evasion. Actually do precision strike if I can get rid of this javelin. No, not quite. Ooh, alright, we got a Vindicator. Alright. See how it's gonna be.
Commander?
Get the lance back together here. Get some evasion on that Phoenix Hawk. More importantly, if we can get that large laser in the center torso. Nice. There goes the javelin.
Mech destroyed.
Ooh, fleet. Alright. I would love to get some more salvage on a flea. I haven't seen a flea since our first mission. I thought they would be more common. Just kind of rotate around. We've got an enforcer. Ooh, significant. We've got a good hit percentage on that enforcer. Lousy hit percentage on that flea. Good hit percentage on this Vindicator. I feel like we need to start working on this enforcer. Also impair his sensors a little bit. Ooh, Panther became the Enforcer's primary target. I can actually live with that.
Yep.
Alright, so we're gonna see here. So we're going to do a little jump with the assassin, just try to get his evasion up a little. He's got really good hit percentages on this flea. We're going to take that shot. Don't want that flea running around too much. I knew that Vindicator was going to go after my assassin. I knew it.
Yes, Commander.
Good hit percentages on this enforcer. I feel like we gotta take this shot. Enforcer v enforcer.
Standing by.
Right. Need to get somebody working on this Vindicator here. see the heat build up here on this Phoenix Hawk, so all we have is a large laser. Let's see what this Lee does. Lee comes in on the assassin. Ooh. The light goes after the light killer. Like to do is try to keep this enforcer focused on the panther. Maybe. Ooh, no, 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 no.
Internal structure, damn it.
Alright. Alright, assassin. You need to,
I got you.
You need to make yourself scarce here. Ooh, nice hit on that flea there.
Reporting. Critical hit.
Pilot injury. Switches to the Phoenix Hawk, which I can live with for a round.
Barely hit, Commander. Commander?
Speaking of the Phoenix Hawk, do we...
solid.
Can't really shoot here, so, going to kind of brace there and cool off. I wanted to get the Phoenix Hawk behind the
Alright,
I've got my... I'd really like to get this flea off the field, but I feel like we need to keep hitting this enforcer.
Roger that.
Guys, do flee against my enforcer. I can live with that.
Yes, Commander.
Right.
Yes, Commander.
The panther to keep this enforcer focused on it.
Target's taking a critical hit.
Nice hit. See if the enforcer goes after here. After the assassin. Fortunately, it missed. Nice.
Waiting for order.
So, let's use our Phoenix Hawk both to achieve our primary objective. And it can get a nice... some nice shots in the rear of this Vindicator. Really gonna do a lot of damage there, but it can at least distract the Vindicator. Vindicator wants to go after the Enforcer. Instead, Enforcer
on my way.
Needs to keep hitting this other Enforcer. We're gonna go for a precision strike. If I could get the leg on this enforcer.
Roger that.
No, of course that won't work. Be too good to be true. Jumping the assassin.
I got you.
Shot got in on that flea.
Critical hit!
We have the asset, Commander.
Let's see if the flea does. Flamer against the Enforcer. I can live with that. Alright.
Reporting!
Let's put our Panther in front of our Assassin. Just
a shot got through my armor.
Really?
Commander.
Get put in a bad place here.
Heading out.
Try to get this leg again. Actually, I don't need to get the leg. I just need to try to knock him down, right? So
firing all the way.
Second pilot injury.
Critical hit, Commander.
Commander? I'm there.
Try to keep this assassin out of harm's way.
I'm on.
Okay.
Let's keep them on.
I can live with that.
What's the plan?
Try to hit this. There goes the Enforcer. That flea is just problematic.
Armor breach. My heat gauge is getting pretty high. Orders.
Vindicator versus Panther.
Minimal damage. Minimal.
I'll take that decision right there all day. Now what we need to do, we need an Enforcer to start hitting this Vindicator.
Engage.
Waiting for orders. Rolling.
Use the Phoenix Hawk as well. Really nice if we could take out that PPC on that Vindicator. He's coming in for melee. Always comical.
Awaiting orders. As you wish.
Need some multi-target here.
Piece of cake.
Vindicator goes after the Enforcer.
Reporting minimal damage.
Again, I can can kind of live with that. Move up the assassin. See if he can finish off this flea. This flea is just annoying. Which is the whole point of a flea, right? I'd love to use this enforcer to squish that flea, but first of all, he has a good chance of missing. Because fleas are hard to hit with melee. And second of all, we need to keep hitting this vindicator. Flea comes in for melee again. I gotta give the flea credit. It's persistent, right? You multi-target again. Eventually, this flea's gonna go down. There we go. There goes the flea. Alright.
Let's do this.
Vindicator did not fire. Alright, we got one AC shot left. Let's make it count. Vindicator. Oh, there goes the PPC off that Vindicator. Really good news there. All right, our assassin is going to get out of the line of fire. Ooh, nice pilot injury on that LRM-5 shot. This is about where you'll get some ridiculous head injury from one SRM missile or something crazy like that. The enforcer's out of missiles, so it's pretty much just large lasers here. Nice hit on that center torso. Do a targeted strike here, see if we can finish this guy off. Yes!
That's a kill!
Alright. Mission successful. We should get some decent salvage out of this one. Damage on my assassin. Not happy about that. Got an enforcer part. Well, we got two parts of a javelin. Not my favorite mech, but I mean, it's a mech. Vindicator part. Got a flea part. And small lasers are sometimes harder to come by than you would think, so sometimes people say in the comments, why do you grab small lasers? Small lasers are actually pretty useful for their tonnage. They're one of the most efficient weapons in the game. You do 20 damage for half a ton versus a medium laser who does 25 damage for a ton. You know, theoretically, I'd rather have two small lasers than one medium laser, right? It's double the damage, almost double the damage. 80, 120%, 140% of the damage. All right, so let's see what's going on. We're going to have to do some repairs to our assassin here. How long is it going to be? 3 days. Don't really have a choice. We got to repair. Put the assassin in the queue. So we got a enforcer, a phoenix hawk, a panther, and a javelin. Got to work with. That's what we got to work with, right? Yeah, they don't pay us not to go on missions. So let's see. Multi-target.
Training complete.
Reporting.
Training confirmed, Commander.
Reading you. How might I help?
Wow. That voice does not sound like an Angus. I just need to change this.
Standing by. Yeah. Right here.
You know what?
I'm here.
That could be an Angus.
Waiting for orders. Awaiting orders. Receiving you. Commander?
Alright, that was a little Irish brawl. You know, like, Irish sounding name. Irish. There, so let's do that.
Mech warrior training complete. Training complete.
Receiving. Standing by.
Yeah, it sounds like.
Order. Waiting for orders.
Yup.
Ooh, I can actually make Twinkle my sensor walker. I definitely want to do that now. That is good. I finally have a sensor locker.
Receiving
will come in really
ready
handy, especially if my assassin is out of commission, because I need something to help me take out light mechs. So sensor lockers are usually good. All right, so that's going to do it for this video. We'll be back soon with another video, so please subscribe to either Commando Gaming or BattleTech Battles for our next episode of Night Terrors Phantoms. We'll see you soon on those channels.